In this example, we will examine a rigid body problem in which one point on the body is constrained to move in a certain direction. A slender rod of length L and mass M has a roller attached at point A. The rod is released from rest in a vertical position with the roller on a surface that is inclined at an angle theta. At this instant, what is the acceleration of point A? And what is the angular acceleration of the rod, alpha? Start by drawing a free body diagram of the rod. Identify your coordinate system and label the positive direction of your coordinates. In this case, a rectangular coordinate system is more convenient. Draw the external forces acting on the rod. The weight acts at the center of mass and points downward. Its magnitude is the mass of the rod, m, times the gravitational acceleration, g. The normal force exerted by the surface on the roller, n, acts perpendicular to the surface at an angle theta relative to the vertical. Next, draw the equivalent kinetic diagram. Select a positive direction for rotation. Draw the components of the acceleration of the center of mass and draw the moment about the center of mass, ICM times alpha. We are ready to apply the three equations of motion: Newton's second law in the x direction, Newton's second law in the y direction, and the moment equation about the center of mass. For the x direction, the x component of the normal force points in the negative x direction. This is equation number 1. For the y direction, the y component of the normal force points in the positive y direction and the weight points in the negative y direction. This is equation number 2. For the moment equation, the moment of inertia about the center of mass, ICM, is the mass times the length squared divided by 12. Next, we determine the moment about the center of mass produced by the external forces. The normal force produces a positive moment and has a moment arm of 1/2 L times sine theta. The weight produces no moment because its moment arm is zero. And now we have equation number 3. We have used the three equations of motion, but have four unknowns: n, alpha, and the two components of the acceleration of the center of mass. Additionally, we want to find the acceleration of point A. We can obtain two additional equations by examining the relative motion between point A and the center of mass. The acceleration of point A is equal to the acceleration of the center of mass plus the acceleration of point A relative to the center of mass. Although we do not know the magnitude of point A's acceleration, we do know point A must accelerate along the surface. The acceleration of point A is decomposed into its x and y components. The x component of the acceleration is the magnitude of acceleration times cosine theta and points in the negative x direction. The y component of the acceleration is the magnitude of acceleration times sine theta and points in the negative y direction. ACM is decomposed into its x and y components. The relative acceleration term is decomposed into tangential and normal components. The tangential component is alpha cross RACM, the position vector from the center of mass to point A. The normal component is the angular velocity of the rod, omega, cross the quantity omega cross RACM. The angular velocity is zero at that instant, since the rod starts from rest. The angular acceleration vector has the magnitude of alpha and points in the z direction. RACM starts at the center of mass and terminates at point A. Point A is located 1/2 L up from the center of mass. take the cross product of alpha and RACM and plug in the expressions for the accelerations. Equating the x terms and the y terms, we obtain two additional equations. Now we have five equations and five unknowns, and can solve for the acceleration of point A and the angular acceleration of the rod.